The Stop the War Coalition is a coalition, involves lots of people, lots of different backgrounds, outlooks and ideas, but we're united in the cause of peace, we're united against any attacks against Iran. We've always had enormous support from the artistic and cultural community in this country, and I want you to give a very warm welcome to one of the greatest actors this country has produced, great campaigner for peace and justice. Please welcome Roger Lloyd Pack.
Well, thank you very much for that introduction, Jeremy. I can't believe that we're having to be here again to protest about the possibility of going to war against Iran. I'm speechless, really, that anyone's even contemplating the idea of going to war in the Middle East after the appalling devastation and destruction that happened in Iraq. I can't think that anyone thinks that it could be a good idea, that it's as if the war in Iraq never happened, or that we've forgotten about it. We've forgotten about the lies that were told to us and are now being told to us again. So I'm absolutely speechless about it. So I'm not going to say any speeches. I'm going to use somebody else's words. I'm going to leave the speeches to people who are better qualified than me. I'm going to do what I tend to do best, which is say somebody else's words. And in this case, it's the words of the great First World War poet, Wilfred Owen. It's a poem called Strange Meeting, which I learnt when I was about 15, and it's lived with me for nearly 50 years, over 50 years, actually. And unfortunately, it still needs to be said. And things haven't changed very much since those days, just maybe the scale of things, so I don't even know about that. So this is called Strange Meeting. It seemed that out of battle I escaped down some profound dull tunnel, long since scooped through granites which titanic wars had groined. Yet also there encumbered sleepers groaned, too fast in thought or death to be bestirred. Then as I probed them, one sprang up and stared with piteous recognition in fixed eyes, lifting distressful hands as if to bless. And by his smile I knew that sullen hall, by his dead smile I knew we stood in hell. With a thousand pains that vision's face was grained, yet no blood reached there from the upper ground, and no guns thumped or down the flues made moan. Strange friend, I said, here is no cause to mourn. None, said the other, save the undone years, the hopelessness. Whatever hope is yours was my life also. I went hunting wild after the wildest beauty in the world, which lies not calm in eyes or braided hair, but mocks the steady running of the hour. And if it grieves, grieves richlier than here. For by my glee might many men have laughed, and of my weeping something had been left which must die now. I mean the truth untold, the pity of war, the pity war distilled. Now men will go content with what we spoiled, or discontent boil bloody and be spilled. They will be swift with swiftness of the tigress. None will break ranks, though nations trek from progress. Courage was mine and I had mystery. Wisdom was mine and I had mastery to miss the march of this retreating world into vain citadels that are not walled. Then, when much blood had clogged their chariot wheels, I would go up and wash them with sweet wells, even with truths that lie too deep for taint. I would have poured my spirit without stint, but not through wounds, not on the cess of war. Foreheads of men have bled when no wounds were. I am the enemy you killed, my friend. I knew you in this dark, for so you frowned yesterday through me as you jabbed and killed. I parried, but my hands were loath and cold. Let us sleep now. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much for listening.
You were here and you heard Roger recite. Fantastic. Better than 1,000 speeches. Roger, thank you very, very much for that and for all you do for the peace movement in this country.